Hello guys, welcome back with me, Chow Chow 2025. Today we're going to learn about how to install and use ComfyUI for Stable Diffusion. If you already have Automatic 1111, we're also going to show you how to integrate Automatic 1111 model from Checkpoint, LoRa, ControlNet, and other into ComfyUI, so you don't have redundant data that will save you a lot of hard disk space. ComfyUI is the most powerful and modular Stable Diffusion GUI and backend. This UI will let you design and execute advanced Stable Diffusion pipelines using a flowchart-based interface. With that, you will have a very flexible but fast generation. Also, it could do almost all what Automatic 1111 can do, and more. So, there are many things that you can only do in ComfyUI that you can't do in Automatic 1111. First, to install ComfyUI, you do just need to access the ComfyUI GitHub at github.com/comfy-anonymous/comfyui. Then, scroll down and go to Installing, Windows. Just click the direct link to download. It will download a 7s file. You could open 7z with many software, or you could download the 7z software at 7dazip.org. Anyway, download the 7z file and extract it. Access the ComfyUI Windows Portable. Enter the update folder. Double-click update comfyui.bat. Or you could also double-click update comfyui and python dependencies.bat if you want. After that finished, then go back to your comfyui Windows portable directory and run vidia-gpu.bat. You technically could run with CPU, but it will be very slow, and I don't recommend it. The first time you use Comfy, you will given a standard workflow remain you of the vanilla Automatic 1111. Since this is the first time you use this, you will not have any checkpoint model. So the first thing to do is to integrate your Automatic 1111 installation with Comfy. Or if you have only Comfy, you could download your checkpoint model and put it on ComfyUI Windows Portable /ComfyUI/ComfyUI/checkpoints. Comfy also support LoRa and a bunch of other things. Check the models directory for the list. Now I assume you have Automatic 1111 already, so the next thing you do is to access Windows Portable /ComfyUI. Search for extra_model_path.yaml.example. Rename the model by removing the dot example. So it became extra_model_path.yaml. You could also copy-paste the file to make a backup. Open the file using any text editor. Change the base path into your Automatic 1111 path. For my PC, that means D:\Soft\StableDiffusion3/WebUI. Unless you have a custom location setting for your model, all should already set up now. If somehow you put your model in other location, set up manually here for checkpoint, LoRa, and other. Now, save the file and reopen ComfyU. Now you will have a model and load checkpoint node.
Okay, guys. First time you load ComfyU, it will look like this. If you are kind of confused, just remember the regular Automatic 1111 Stable Diffusion. First, you have load checkpoint here. This is where you load the checkpoint. From here, you see these three things here. It's model, clip, and file. It's the output. So it's just the clip you are continuing here. Here, see if you this thing called nodes. See here, clip here. This is an input. This is an input. So in order to move this, you need to move a clip output to a clip input. From the load, there are three outputs here, model, clip, and file. First, clip, this is a prompt. You put in a prompt, this is positive prompt, this is a negative prompt. It actually doesn't matter if you put negative or positive here, as long as you connect it. The second output, that is key sampler here. Conditioning, you put it on the positive and the negative. And the models is continue from here to here. And this guy need one more input, that is latent image. We don't have any latent image, so we add this thing here. This is the image setting that you're gonna use, like instead of the width and the height. From here is the regular sampler, it's seed, randomize, step, GFG, set 7, sampler name, use cars, EM SD, scheduler, we change it to cars, the noise. Then from here, latent, the output is latent. So you put latent into samples. It's the same. File, you got it file from the models, or you have load your own file. Here we're going to save the image. Now, this is regular automatic 1111 output. In here, we use this node here. We don't load anything else, so like you see, when you load this for the first time, it's going to be pretty fast, unlike you load Stable Diffusion, because it's going to put the node that only that you use. Well, automatic 1111 will force you to load everything. Let's prompt. We're going to run here. See the green thing? This is currently in the process. Yeah. You change this to whatever you want. You go with scary face, yeah. Scary face. You prompt again. This is more fun, right? Face. Process is the same, you know. Off. By loading this, gonna save a lot of time. Of course, you could quit a lot. I'm going to do this 8 times. If you do the query, delete it, clear it, you know, whatever you want. Sorry. And yeah, this is the original automatic 1111. For example, if you want to do something like at a new node, for example, we want to do high res machine, we could add our load upscale model here. For example, we scan load is doesn't have anything. We could add another node that is loaded log using image upscaling image user models. Okay, from here we need the model here, upscale image, and we could take the image here since save image doesn't have output from Latin, but image from file decode because this is the OBD's image. And from here we could actually add a node again that is save image. Or if you don't want to save, we could just add for view. Let's just save. QI upscale. Let's go to save here. I'm going to put here. Let's play it again. Get sampler. It's going to save the regular image. This is the one that being upscale, I guess. Could add actually a setup here of how much it's being upscale. We don't set up anything, it's a fault for 4 times, but you know, you could like check it if it's work. Glare. This is the upscale. Be a different. See if we zoom more, you can see the different, right? Ask more details. This is 4 times the size. No, see? Anyway, guys, I think that's it. There's a lot of things you could do using ComfyUI. And more than even what the Automatic 1111 can offer. And you don't actually need to design this thing by yourself. There's a lot of workflow that you could use, that you could save, and you could load. So that's it for today's video. The next time we access ComfyUI, I'm going to inform you about Manager, because that's the most important thing, I guess. But for now, use this, you know, just tinker it yourself. Because, you know, when you got the manager, when you got the workflow, at least you know how it works, so you can actually edit it or modify it by yourself. So for now, just tinker with this, add node, remove node and stuff. That's it for me, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment, and see you again on the next episode. Have a nice day.